These are certain questions which have been asked. I will try to answer them as far as possible. The answer may be not fully adequate. I have tried to find them from people who have been advising. And the recommendation may change from time to time, as we know, as the situation is fluid. People have been asking questions from the counseling centers, and these are some of the questions which have been put. How do we catch the COVID-19 virus? How does it spread to other people? And how do we test for it? We can catch the virus from a positive patient who may or may not have symptoms. Therefore, use of a mask and social distancing are the best tools we have to prevent spread of this virus. It may also be contracted from touching surfaces that have been contaminated with the virus. Therefore, wash your hands frequently or use a hand sanitizer and clean the most commonly touched surfaces at home and work with a sanitizer or soap and water. Question: what are the steps I am supposed to take if I have been to Bethany Hospital and developed symptoms at home? If you have been to Bethany Hospital since the 22nd of March, the government guidelines are clear. Quarantine yourself at home and inform 108. Do not wait for symptoms to start to quarantine yourself, because by then you may spread the virus to other members of your family and others too. If, however, you have developed symptoms, immediately inform 108 or 1070 and tell them when you were at Bethany and that you have developed symptoms. A question: a lot of people say that this virus is like a flu. How do I treat it at home? Some say paracetamol is enough to cure it. Yes, the virus does cause a flu-like illness and is very difficult to differentiate from it. The only way we can do it is by using very sensitive tests that differentiate the virus from others causing similar illness. As of now, there is no treatment for the virus. However, it is important to keep in mind that 80% of the population develop mild symptoms and do not need to be hospitalized. 80% once more. Of the remaining 20%, only 5% need ICU care. In these 20% who need hospitalization, the largest group overwhelmingly are those which have risk. And what are these risk factors? It is important for you to know. So, if you have symptoms and you have these risk factors, then it is important. Age more than 60 years, pre-existing heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, other chronic lung ailments, kidney and liver disease, cancer, and other forms of immunosuppression. Paracetamol helps in relieving fever and body ache, but it does not lead to cure of the infection. Question: when should I be worried about my symptoms? Do I need to go to a hospital? Whom should I call? Call 108. What are the symptoms that you should be looking for? Fever, cough, difficulty in breathing. Sometimes body ache, stomach upset, and loss of smell. This is one of the important features now, if we know, loss of smell or taste. There are only two reasons as of now for hospitalization. The first is difficulty in breathing, and the second is if you have any risk factors as mentioned above. If you have risk factors, then even if you have mild disease, it is advisable to mention the same to 108 and go to hospital. Question: we live in a very small house and we share a common bathroom. How do we practice self-isolation? Is this different from quarantine? Self-isolation is a form of quarantine that occurs at home or your place of dwelling. If you have a small house, it is not easy to do. The best course of action is to inform 108 or 1070 and tell them your situation so that you can request for admission to a corona care center. If the above is not possible, try to sleep in a separate bed at least 6 feet away from everyone. Wear a mask at all times. Avoid speaking directly to any family member and try to employ a barrier between you and that member. Eat separately and wash your own plate and hands thoroughly using soap and water. The latest studies say that this form of quarantine in a small house with other family members is not suitable. A coronary care center is better. Question: what is PPE? Everyone is talking about it nowadays. Do I need it? PPE is a name for personal protective equipment. This refers to the coverings that we employ to protect anyone in close contact with a known or suspected patient. It includes hood, goggles, a mask, which may be of different types depending on the risk, a face shield, a full body gown, shoe covers and gloves, which may be up to 3 pairs at a time depending on the need. As a member of the public, you do not need it. A mask, hand sanitizer or soap and water, and social distancing are all that are required. Maintain these in the best possible way and remind others also, this is important, remind others also around you to do the same. Avoid spitting indiscriminately. Remember, this is good manners as well as for this disease. Question: a staff from Bethany Hospital was present at a social gathering with me. Should I be worried? No, you do not need to be worried unless you are in close contact for a prolonged period of time. I shared a meal with a person who has been a visitor to Bethany Hospital. Should I be worried? No, you need not be worried unless the person was in close contact with a known positive case. If I face other ailments apart from fever, cough, and I need medication but the police won't allow me, what should I do? First and foremost, carry your prescription if you have one with you. If you are refused permission, call 108-1070 and explain the problem calmly and do not panic. If the situation is an emergency, the police will not obstruct you. Question: I work at a bank. One of the staff of the Bethany Hospital came and had contact with me. What do I do? Our answer is, did you maintain social distancing? If yes, then it should not be a worry. If you are in close contact for a prolonged period of time, that is the difference. If you have maintained social distancing, do not worry. If you are in close contact for a prolonged period of time, it would be advisable to inform 108 and practice self-isolation. Question: one of my family members have come back from an affected state, or one of my family members have come back from Bethany Hospital. Can I catch the virus by washing her clothes and dishes? No, washing of dishes does not pose a hazard if a few precautions are taken. You need to wear a mask and gloves and wash the dishes thoroughly with soap and running water. And first, do not shake or agitate the clothes excessively. Soak them in hot water and ordinary detergent or soap if you do not have a washing machine. If you use a washing machine, set the temperature to 60 to 90 degrees Celsius. Use a mask and gloves and dry all the clothes thoroughly, preferably in the sun. Somebody has asked a question: I want to be a responsible citizen and I want to reduce the transmission chances. Please give me some advice so that I can practice individually, as a member of family and as a member of a closed compound. The best way you can do this is by social distancing again yourself from others, whether on a personal basis, as a family member or a member of a closed compound. If you are a suspect, then isolate yourself and maintain precautions mentioned earlier. Wear a mask at all times. I want to get tested because it will give me peace of mind if my result is negative. Should I do this? Testing for this disease is a science, and it will turn positive only after the virus is present in sufficient quantities in your nasopharynx and oropharynx. The virus will remain in these secretions for a variable amount of time, but is usually negative after 3 weeks. Therefore, testing of the disease for the disease at the right time is important. Testing at the wrong time can lead to a false sense of security if found negative. There are two tests available, the RT-PCR and the antibody test, rapid diagnostic test. These are different ways to test the disease. I will not go into detail for this. I have a newborn baby. I just visited Bethany Hospital. Can I still breastfeed my child? In view of the information we have so far, and this may change, if you do not have any symptoms, it is likely safe to breastfeed your child after you have washed your hands and your breasts with soap and water. If you have symptoms, the first thing to do is to use a mask and breastfeed with frequent washing with soap and water of your hands and the breasts. What do I do if there are other medical emergencies which are unrelated to the COVID-19 virus? For example, my father needs a dialysis, or my mother has some heart condition which will need immediate care. You can visit any hospital that has the facilities to treat a family member for the same. If there's any problem, please call the numbers which are available. There is a lockdown and curfew and I have a medical emergency. However, the police or the Shillong stopped me from going because I violate the curfew or lockdown. How do I convince them or whom do I call? As mentioned earlier, explain the urgency of the situation. If necessary, ask them to see the patient after they have masked themselves, employed social distancing and proper hand washing. If there is still a problem, call 108 or 107 and explain the problem. Question. These days, there are a lot of forwarded messages, screenshots, videos, and so on. How do I confirm their credibility? Never believe everything that you see or read on social media. Some of it will be true, but most of this information is false or partially false and is not based on fact. It is very difficult to sort out the true from the false, and in view of this, wait for press releases from the concerned authorities in the government. Question: a person just passed away due to coronavirus and he or she is very close to me. Can I attend the funeral? If yes, how do I protect myself? If no, may I know the reason why? No, it is advisable to stay away despite the difficulty in doing so and the emotional bonds involved. The reason for this is that there may be other positive persons who are from the immediate family. They may pose a risk of infection to others around them. Emotional reactions that happen during a death or burial are part of human nature, which may lead to acts of love and kindness involving hugging and crying, which pose a risk to others. And this is a very sensitive issue we are dealing with, and naturally we understand the frustrations, anger and sadness involved. However, for the interests of all, it is safer to follow what is mentioned above. Question: we live in a small house and our family member is working with the government who has to report to work. Should we be worried as we don't know how to isolate? There should be no reason to worry. When the person goes to work, he or she must use a mask and socially distance themselves from others while performing their work and wash hands with soap and water frequently. Should we count 21 days from the time we met with someone from Bethany or from the day the first case was declared? 14 days is the accepted period as of now from the time of your contact. To be absolutely sure, if it is practically possible, 28 days may be acceptable. At what time do we know we have to report for testing because we have been told to just observe our symptoms and isolate? As mentioned earlier, development of any symptoms, especially breathlessness, is when you will have to report, for the instructions will be given to you.